1994. From out of space comes a runaway planet, hurtling between the Earth and the Moon, unleashing cosmic destruction. Man's civilization is cast in ruin. 2,000 years later, Earth is reborn. A strange new world rises from the old. A world of savagery, super science, and sorcery. But one man bursts his bonds to fight for justice. With his companions, Ookla the Mock and Princess Ariel, he pits his strength, his courage, and his fabulous sun sword against the forces of evil. He is Thundar, the Barbarian.
TGIF, Jennings County. I'm Damon, and you are watching JCTV News. The end of the first 9 weeks will be coming to an end next Friday. Ball State will be here for a college visit on Tuesday. There will be an SAT test tomorrow morning. Be sure to bring your ID and keep your phone in your car. Fall break will begin a week from today. The Oktoberfest in Seymour will run through tomorrow night. Jennings County Middle School is looking for certified lifeguards to work at the pool. If you're interested, contact Mike Wagner at the middle school. Finally, there will be a college and career expo at the high school auxiliary gym on Thursday, October 24th, from 6 until 8 p.m. It is finally starting to feel like fall. Here's your 7-day weather forecast.
I'm Kyle Form, and here's your 7-day weather forecast. Friday will be breezy and cooler with a high of 68 and a low of 46. Saturday will have pleasant evening showers with a high of 75 and a low of 55. Sunday will have few showers possible with a high of 71 and a low of 50. Monday will be sunny with a high of 67 and a low of 46. Tuesday will be mild with a high of 69 and a low of 45. Wednesday will be sunny with a high of 69 and a low of 55. And Thursday will have storms with a high of 68 and a low of 55. The average high will be 70 and the average low will be 49 degrees.
Thanks. It is the final home football Friday night. Here's your sports.
lay. What's up? Yeah. Yeah.
Kane is in the building, nigga.
Yeah. It's alright, already the show goes on all night. Till the morning we dream so long. Anybody ever wonder when they would see the thunder? Just remember when you come to the show.
Sports fans, the volleyball team fell to Scottsburg in four sets on Thursday night. Hannah Bersham had 19 digs and Abby Vogel had 7 kills. The boys tennis team came to an end last night. The boys fell to Southwestern 3-2. Winning was the singles players of Wyatt St. John and Justin Ramey. The boys football team is 3-3 on the year. We'll be looking for the fourth win of the year tonight, a home game against Floyd Central. In the regional action, Columbus East will be at B&L. Bloomington South will be at Columbus North. Madison will host Jeff, and Seymour will host New Albany. FCA meets every Thursday at 7:15 in Mr. Cummings Room, 210. On the college level, Indiana will host Rutgers tomorrow afternoon. Purdue will be at Penn State, and Notre Dame will be at Bowling Green. On the national level, unbeaten Kansas City will play at the Colts. Here's a look at tonight's weekend sporting events. Tonight, the football team will host Floyd Central. It is senior night, and you can listen to the game on WJCP Radio or here on our school channel. On Saturday, the freshman football team will be at Floyd, and the junior varsity team will be at Floyd Central, too. This is the latest in sports. Back to the news desk.
It's Friday. Time for another movie trailer.
Can you please stop bothering my kid?
Sorry.
Arthur, I have some bad news for you. This is the last time we'll be meeting.
You don't listen, do you? You just ask the same questions every week. How's your job? Are you having any negative thoughts? All I have are negative thoughts.
And finally, in a world where everyone thinks they can do my job, check out this guy.
When I was a little boy and told people I was gonna be a comedian, everyone laughed at me. Well, no one's laughing now.
You can say that again, pal.
So awful, isn't it?
For my whole life, I didn't know if I even really existed. But I do. And people are starting to notice.
You think this is funny? Is this a joke to you?
Murray, one small thing.
Yeah.
When you bring me out, can you introduce me as Joker?
Send in the clown.
Here's a look at October 4th in this day in history.
October 4th, 1957. Dawn of the space age as the Soviet Union launches Sputnik, the first man-made satellite, into orbit. 1993. A bloody battle in Somalia's capital, Mogadishu. Two U.S. Black Hawk helicopters are shot down while gun battles rage between American forces and guerrilla fighters. Amid the fighting, dozens of Somalis drag the body of an American soldier through the city's streets. President Bill Clinton soon decides to withdraw U.S. troops from Somalia by the following year. 1895. Buster Keaton, one of the great comedy stars of the silent movie era, is born in Piqua, Kansas. And 1970. Rock singer Janis Joplin is found dead of an accidental heroin overdose in her Hollywood hotel room. Joplin, a music icon for the 60s counterculture, was 27 years old. Today in history, October 4th, Camille Bohannon, The Associated Press.
Let's see what's making internet news.
Mr. B-17.
This particular airplane was born in 1944, so it's going to have its 70th birthday here this November. When we land, people go, "Is that a bomber B-17? And we always say, "Yes, it is."
It was a tough old bird. You could shoot it all to pieces and it'd still keep going.
Coming in with his left inboard engine dead, feathered prop, a chunk of tail gone.
I've seen some that you would swear, how did it get back? There's nothing left. But they did.
They flew home on their luck.
How many are left?
A few thousand of these babies will win this war for us, and a few thousand guys like you in there flying.
I was a ball turret gunner, underneath. It's the only place you can fight a war and lay on your back at the same time.
So let's go and take a look around. Let's meet the team. Yes, sir, nine fellas like yourself working together, closely coordinated as a precision watch.
We wore heated suits. I wore gloves. You can't touch metal at 60 below zero. If you do, use part of it.
Plain guys who wanted to do something for their country.
This is sort of a trip down memory lane for me. Put it this way, I wouldn't take $1 million for having done it. I wouldn't do it again for $1 billion if you promised me the same result. There were some good times and some bad times. Good memories, bad memories. We just keep on keeping them.
Breakfast at the high school on Monday will be bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit, fruit choice, juice, and milk. Monday's lunch will be quesadilla or crispy chicken, baked french fries or steamed carrots, fruit choice, and milk. Don't have cable and don't watch our school channel on the internet? We can be found on our website. Check us out at www.jcse.org. Our news program can be seen Monday through Saturday at 2:56, 5:30, 7:30, and 9 p.m. Then it replays the following day at 8 a.m. and 11 a.m. Does your nonprofit group have something to announce on our school channel? Send us an email at tv@jcse.org. That's the weekend show. The Blue Day crew will be here for the Monday show. See ya!
SCC was Indiana's first cooperative career center.
SCC serves 12 high schools in 6 counties.
SCC students earned over 3,000 college credits last year.
SCC has 28 classes and 15 different CTE programs.
95% of SCC's co-op students signed employment contracts before they graduated from high school.
SCC's graduation rate is better than the state and national average.
SCC has 8 buildings for classrooms and labs on 48 acres.
SCC students earned 745 industry certifications last year.
SCC has over $3 million in equipment for students to use and learn with.
SCC is a Vincent University Early College School.
SCC saved their school districts over $300,000 last year by combining services.
The staff at SCC has over 250 years of combined teaching experience.